who have some sweets or chocolates distributed. I'd request that, you know, each one of you should be given a chocolate. That's in the chamber. Okay, so while that's being done, I again assure you that we will definitely collaborate with the Chamber of Tax Consultants again for different topics and different workshops, and please do take part in it. And I request Vipul Bhai to now introduce the speaker.
Friends, we started our session with Mr. D.D. Rathi, a very, you know, learned person, very experienced, with very rich experience in industry. And we have Mr. Sudhir Walia to give his concluding remarks on this seminar on CFO. We couldn't have a better person than Mr. Walia because of the simple reason that Sun Pharma has been awarded the company of the year for the 2012 by Economic Times. To briefly introduce Mr. Sudhir Walia, he is a member of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and carries more than 3 decades of taxation and finance experience. He has been the director of Sun Pharma since its inception and is also on the board of Taro Pharmaceuticals Limited. He serves as non-executive and non-independent director of Sun Pharma Advanced Research Company Limited. Mr. Walia has won CNBC TV 18 CFO of the Year in the pharmaceutical and healthcare sectors in 2006, 2009, and 2012. Apart from this, he has also been awarded the Adivasi Sevak Puraskar for the year 2008-09 by the government of Maharashtra for his contribution towards the welfare of tribals, particularly in the field of education, in his capacity as director of the Shantilal Sanghvi Foundation in Krishna Vrindavan Pratishtan. A very brief biodata, but a biodata of substance. Mr. Walia, thank you very much for making it, and may I request all of you to welcome him with a loud applause. And I request Mr. Shailesh Vaidya, the president of IMC, to present him a memento. Coincidentally, initials of both the gentlemen is same, SV to SV. Mr. Walia.
If I... perfectly fine.
I'm more comfortable, and I hope...
No, I'm audible. Yes, no issue. Fine. So I really thank to the chamber and the organizer to giving me an opportunity, especially for winding up session, and then note which associated with that expectation from a CFO, which the stakeholders, and there are a number of stakeholders which we understand in every organizations which we have, and also they expect me to put remark on personal education and family, how I manage or how one should manage the time when such a onerous work of a CFO being there with. Friends, I just would like to make small corrections for benefit and comfort to all of you about what Vipul said about me, that since inception of the Sun Pharma, no, I was not since inception in Sun Pharma. Sun Pharma started somewhere in 81 by my brother-in-law. I started my practice as a chartered accountant in 79, and I did practice up to 93 end. So I was like one of you. I don't know how many you are in practice. most, if it is so, then I just amongst you. Also, I have attended some more of seminars that the RRC generally being dead, either of chamber or of BCA, whichever is convenient to me in the time point. So please be feel free with me. I am very comfortable, and we started with the lollipop in the advance. So I am more comfortable with you. Now coming back to the subject which we talk about, really the CFO, the expectation is more than a CEO from the CFO, because anything which goes wrong, ultimately it will be blamed to CFO. And even if you study the Sarbanes-Oxley and other regulatory provisions in the US, the CFO is expected to sign first before CEO about the accounts and confirming that nothing has gone wrong in the company altogether, which is something beyond. So the business is involved, business issues are there. Finance is one of the part, but we agree that the finance is the most crucial and vital part of the business. And if finance is not handled in a proper manner, there will be more disaster than the success. So that when you have such a onerous work, definitely you have a lot to deliver, lot more for you to have a stress in a environment where you are expecting to deliver, and the expectation of the stakeholders, which starts from the investors. The investor is expecting generally with you about the growth in the value of the shares, primarily if it is a listed. If not listed, then anyway the value in terms of the profit of the company, by which definitely they see that how that maximize. So they actually are not very long term on the subject, but they would like to see that how fast the company's valuation can go. So that's how the one sector of the people who looks that everything should be looked more favorably to him. Now the question comes here with CFO is how to manage that expectation with the resources which always are limited. And if we see the history, the CEO or CFO who has performed well, who has managed allocation of the finance very well. We all heard hero Jack Welch, and thereafter Harry Singleton. I don't know, that name is heard by many people. But the company Teledyne, especially that Singleton, has worked between 63 till 90. Jack Welch has worked between 81 to 2001, when the shareholders' value has grown by 20.9%. In Harry Singleton's time, it was a 27-28 years period, and the value has grown by 20.4% every year. So both of them has done a remarkable, fabulous job. Now, what if I say more about Harry Singleton? What he has done? He was a CEO definitely, but he was more in a finance side, looked finance as a tool for maximizing the benefit. So he, and every opportunity, got buyback of the shares. Up to 1980, he has never declared dividend. He has not diluted. Every acquisitions which he has done through borrowing. So he conserved and preserved the equity, something like a jewel, and actually it has appreciated. The share went up to $180. And that's a history where we now remember this kind of a people. So basically allocation of a resource. See, every business in that you will get an opportunity to decide whether you would like to liquidate when you acquire, would you like to issue shares? And that is very easiest transaction. if the company is successful. Today in Sun Pharma, if I want to buy any other company issuing Sun Pharma shares, it is much appreciated by the other shareholders and it is very easy for me to deal, but I will be issuing, diluting my equity. Now, can I solve that issue of acquiring other company with the help of temporary borrowing? And if my earning is capable enough to meet that, then I should do that. Now, this part is a very crucial decision-making process, and where your decision is more influenced in final decision. Practically, you are taking the decision, I can say, because the investors are at the fence and they will not be able to take a real call. Now, we can't be very greedy also, because there are cases where we have seen that company has continued to borrow and now they are not able to repay, that they had good opportunity in past to issue equity, but they are in greed that they should get more equity, means more valuation for their equity, and they have not issued equity. The market has shrunk. There are a number of such company which we also know. So I am not here for evaluating those company, but definitely I would like a communications where, while deciding the area in which how we should decide, so we should first perceive the risk in the business, that what is the risk, what is the probability of we not being able to repay the debt, and if we are not able to repay the debt, then that will be more difficult, then it is easier or sensible for us to dilute equity at that stage. And equity also is a very sensitive market. The money market is totally sensitive. See, when you don't want money, people will come and give you money. Please believe me what I am saying you. When you are not asking for the money, banker will come and knock your door and say, I want to lend you money, I want to give you money. The day you want money, you are in difficulty. Even who are there standing in front of you will run away. Now, this money you are managing now and you are supposed to manage, then you have to be very clear that when money is available to you, you use it in a proper manner for your growth, for the activity of the company in such a manner that you repay in a timely manner and then create a value for the company and for you. Now, this one segment which we are talking about is the expectation of the investors, where he is looking wealth maximizations, and we have been discussing that we have to weigh between equity borrowing or a debt borrowing, and that is based on the risk what we can take into the business about ability to repay, to generate cash. Definitely when the things are in the favor, everybody is thinking that whatever money we will borrow, we will be able to repay. But I just seen lately when that windmill company Pune, Suzlon, then that is a company in Chennai Ring, they even Alok Industries, all these companies borrowed heavily. They got money at a point of time when the business was in good. Now some of them been forced to issue equity, and Alok lately issued equity at the par. At some point of time their shares went very high. Now I am not criticizing those people, so please, nothing against any individual. I am giving you an example where this decision of yours is very important, and one should not be very greedy at a time when you are raising equity, because every person who is going to invest into your equity is expecting a discount from the market. But it will be sensible for you in a where beyond a risk you should not do it. So anyway, this is one segment where you one stakeholder to whom you have to take handle. Now coming to the next important stakeholder is the auditor. Now, auditor would always have a different perspective of narrating the books of accounts, and he will be very conservative all the time. He is not business oriented, and he would like to see that he should not be answerable. So he always would like to, even given a choice, qualify the reports so that he is not in a difficult zone. And management is on the other side, always finding ways and means that why this presentation should not be done, why these notes are required, why do we have to qualify any income, even if it is one-time income, because we would like to have a rosier picture to be presented to the shareholders. And that striking between the auditor and that is again the next important challenge which all of you will have. Now, definitely, first and foremost, we have to agree that we are not going to change the auditor, because that is not the solution. The next auditor is going to do the same thing. So it is better we find a negotiation techniques with him, ensure that the language doesn't disturb him. At the same time, you achieve your objectives in which what you are looking forward. So auditor, anyway, I have seen not very aggressive, and by and large, they sit with you and find solution with you because of the way their nature are, and that is good. And I don't know how many of you are in the side of audit, but generally I have not seen very aggressive positions so far. The employee expects in the purchase side always that the payment to the customer has to reach in time, supplier has to reach in time. And I come across a financial controller, he says that we don't have to bother for working capital, able that time payable. So working capital comes from all the suppliers, and whenever the funds are available, we will pay them. I think that is the very extreme stage, but the fact I am telling you, I am not just for the sake of saying, because I come across number of pharma company and we do interact, and this is one of the pharma companies CFOs told me. On the contrary, I advise that if you deliver payment in time, you will have all number of queues of supplier want to supply the best quality material, because he is assured of a payment in time. He will be able to find his cash flow management better, and he will be giving you the best of the price. So when you deal with them, we have to have a system to see that the payment reaches in time. So there is number of reason for payment not to reach in time, which all of you in the industry, when it is there, it starts from documentations, excise documentations, quality verifications, and various other parameters to meet before the final approval of the material comes. Because ultimately somebody has to approve the material, and in the factory nobody takes the ownership, nobody want to bell the cat. So in that situation we have to develop the system to ensure that we don't fail in commitment as a company which we give about payment. Same time you will see that your salespeople are looking for a longer time credit. So whenever the delay is taken place from the party who has purchased material, they would like you to waive interest and so forth. Now, we need to manage both the sides. We need to pay in time, we have to collect in time also. So having understood about the buyer, we need to develop systems so that the adequate advance information also goes to him. That on due date, we are going to knock his door and ensure that we are going to take away what is due to us. At the same time, CFO has to manage banker, which is more complex. This banker is a different community. They continue to grab all the security whatever you give, and still he is hungry. The whatever security if you give him for borrowing, it will be less. And he is looking for some more. At the same time, as organizations, the owners or the stakeholders are looking a very minimum amount of security is to be given. And at the same stage, if required, we should be able to keep them away. Now, this is very complex, confusing situations, and that which we have to deal with. I do agree that ultimately every deal which is difficult, but if you don't do deal, it will be more difficult. So we did have to strike between the them. At the same time, government also is one of the stakeholder, and they expect the maximum tax from you, and whatever best manner, whatever you plan for, he will find out relevant or irrelevant reason to pin down you. And again, there is a one great bargain which you have to settle in whatever manner. But that challenge is there because the laws are complicated and it is interpreted complicatedly. But fine. Now see, all these problems are there, and we see day to day this, and there is no one solution to this. So the questions definitely comes at how the CFO will be having a comfortable time, because he has to continue to manage all odds. Everybody is looking ultimately results from him, and he has to see the progress of the company also, and striking the deal between the two. But I take it as an opportunity. See, every difficult time you have a solutions which is out of the box, and if you can think on the subject, you will be able to find a solutions better. And most of you having background of the tax, if you understand the business, you can strike the best deal. I'll give you one or two examples that how structuring can help. And that will be number of ways of doing. This is not the way only. At a point of time, we wanted to buy a office premises in Mumbai. The limitations is that we bargained very hard. Market was very bad in 97. So no buyer were there, and we were the buyer, so we were just like a king. So every builder was giving any price which we write was the acceptable to them. The second issue which was there is that time there was a regulatory which requires approval, prior approval from the income tax. So the property document has to be offered to the income tax regulatory authority. And if they approve the price and deal, you can deal. Otherwise, they have preemptive right to purchase. 37I. Now the deal which I done was about 3,500 rupees, which was below the market price. And the builder was worried that how 37I will come. So we discussed together, we went to the banker. And I said, okay, I'm writing a price of 5,000 rupees, but I'll pay after 3 years. So in the document, the price is 5,000. After 3 years, 30% discounting, my price comes the same. Now builder wants money day one. So I said, okay, I'll give you bank guarantee. But when I went to the bank, bank says they will charge me 3% bank guarantee, which was not affordable to me. So I asked my banker that you give me LC. See, it's a commodity for the builder. He is selling. It is not something, he is buying and selling, it is a commodity for him, it is a maybe real estate for me. So for me, if I go through LC, then I have to hardly pay 0.15 paise charges, LC charges, and that is much, much better. Now, against LC, if the builder is borrowing, then risk weightage is only 20%. The bank who lends money to the builder, he otherwise has to provide 1.5 times of the risk weightage of the money which is given to the builder. But against LC, the risk weightage is 0.2. So our ability to bargain with the bank to give us a lower rate of interest was very high. So against bank's LC, I got a very low rate of interest, so whatever I spent for the LC was nothing. I save much more in interest rate. So I get a higher rate in my document. Builder got the money down. I capitalize the value higher instead of accounting in a every day-to-day interest. For 3 years, I capitalized the asset at the value of 5,000. Because I didn't want it, I had all benefit of tax because of the R&D. So I wanted to postpone my tax benefit. So now this is a structuring which is possible in a day-to-day activity when you get involved into the business. If you are part of a business, you know the transactions, you know the issues, and you know the limitations. Basically, it starts from a situation where we wanted to succeed in 37i. So we wanted a higher price. And we see, because for us, the period is a solution to that. If I defer my payment, I can increase the price. I'll give you one more example, how the things we structured for even dividend, which we didn't wanted to take it, but we wanted to use for the purpose of charitable purpose. We decided that we would like to spend certain money for the charitable purpose, but if I spend money from my pocket, then possibly I will get 80G or some small benefit or whatever may be. So we wanted that if I spend from the company, I will get larger deductions. And we established a trust who get 35AC approval also. Then we declared that in the AGM we will have two category of shares, which shareholder has to in advance tell A and B. B will not get the dividend, but the dividend whatever is waived off, the company declared that they will spend for the purpose of charitable. So otherwise the shares is in normal shares, it is traded in a normal circumstances. But when the window is share trading closed and the next trade running starts, between this period, we designed that category B will come in picture. Category B waived the dividend. So no dividend tax is payable on that by the company because now company is not going to give. Company is given the same money to the donation to 35AC Trust. So company get the deductions 100%. So 35%, 33% whatever tax savings company could get is there. No dividend distribution tax. And the shares was in same category after 5 days. So for the trading purpose, it was not affected. So instead of me taking dividend from the company and spending money, we decided not to take dividend, but we spend money for that object. And we could do that, where 50% of the money I think I covered from the government. It's legally possible, and we are doing. You can read Sun Pharma and you will be able to get all that things what we have done. So there are n number of such things which we can discuss. If anybody has a specific reason come across where they wanted to have any issues or discuss, we can discuss, or I may give some suggestions as a CFO what are the actions one should take for. But I may keep floor open for I given or started one or two ignites. I'll come to that. No, see, Sanha. See, basically, Vipul Bhai is asking that how we created a value in Sun Pharma. Now, see, if you ask me, there is nothing very unique about the company. There is nothing which is very outstanding where the company has knowledge and somebody else doesn't have. We all are otherwise been ordinary company and doing business, but yes, we are very focused. We handle all the issues with the very diligence, with the object that whatever the issues are there today, if I fix it today, then tomorrow it will not appear. And we work with that object to fix today. I may give some of my personal experience. So, up till 97, we used to operate out of Baroda, and I joined them in 93. That is what the correction I made. And managed the finance part out of Mumbai. And before we get the money for the company in the public issue, we created enough debt, taking advantage of the market where we advanced money in the stock market, multiplied our money, and when money we received, we didn't have to have a free float to remain. And that are number of ways by which multiple activity can take place with stock invest and all that. So we leveraged 3 to 4 times the money which we had. And we used to generate more than 25 crore those days out of 50 crore money which we had liquid. But that is a small incident. What more important is that we started focusing each of the business activity and 97 when they shifted here, every day when I go to the office, I think that I will contact so much person or so and so activity I will do. But believe me, I can't do anything except what is there in front of me. Up to 2004, I was only doing firefighting. I started with a simple scenario because having 97, they shifted here. For 2 months, I signed all the checks in the company. Nobody has check signing power. I will sign the checks for all activity across company. And believe me, in 2 months, I never had any time to do anything else than signing check. But after 2 months, till today, I have not signed single check. I've gone through each and every transactions, understood the process, understood the manner in which activity is to be done, corrected where we identified the leakage. At the same time, developed a processes. And I focused on developing a software for the company which will take care all the processes and control of the activities of the company. Today we have homegrown ERP working in the company, and we are multinationals. We have presence in more than 14 countries. We have factories and we have sales. Everybody using the same software. And all compliance is, as on today, done with the help of that same software, including regulatory, and for pharma FDA is more important. So believe me, we did focus on each activity what we do. We use system to help us. Those days I used to have 86 people in finance department, accounts department across company. I am talking 97. To me, still we have not crossed that number after having so many multi locations across the world. It went down up to 54 people somewhere in 2005 and 2006, and there again because of the merger, we acquired so many companies. What I want to emphasize here is that the software which you use, you need to ensure the process of the business and the controls, then I think you have done the maximum thing. The next important thing is you definitely fight when you are right, but not at the cost of the company's loss, or you settle the issue even if you are right. This is a very simple principle. Time is very important. Anything which cost me today 1x is going to cost me 5x tomorrow. And 20x after 1 year, my time will be more important to me after 1 year. It is better I settle him today, though I am right. So we find method to solve the problem on the spot, no pending. Third thing I would like to suggest is that whatever tax which we planned and saved, we invested in research. We use total tax saving for the purpose of growing company. Means somebody may study Sun Pharma. We have never paid more than 3 to 4% tax, though our income crossed 1,000 crore. And that's true. So MAT has so far not affected us. But that savings, we have not kept savings with us. And that is where I expect all of your very important role, that you can plan the business, use the saving of the tax for further growth of the business. Maybe sales is very important in some organization. Then we do structure according to that. I should not advise very simple, but it is fact that most people want to generate cash for reducing tax. I'm most against that, and I say that don't do at all. It takes away all your business ability to run the business. It takes away your attentions and time. It is better you pay tax, plan it, reduce it is different. But don't try to make it, and a structured organization is impossible otherwise also. Rest, anyway, I don't need to discuss about short-term and long-term money, and that interest rate is affected, that is all which is very well known to you. But in the finance business, when you are there, you need to honor your commitment is the most important. And if you are honoring, then you are the most favored people for all the lender to lend you. I think most advice which I wanted to give is there. Anything which, any specific you do suggest me?
Any questions?
Sure. Again, I will explain it. Sure. We have done so many such things. I have given you just tip of the iceberg. But fine. See, as a company, when the AGM is to be called, we, along with our reports and notice, we give options to the shareholders to opt for Class A and Class B. Class B says that no dividend will be paid to you. At the same time, company is making, see, if I direct to the company that whatever dividend which I am forgiving is used for XYZ purpose, then it is still deemed to have been dividend given to me, and I have rights into that, and department can tax me. So I didn't want that. I was very clear, company declared that if somebody is doing like this, then we are going to use this money for so and so purpose. So it is very abundant clear. When I say that the window close thereafter, that exercise of the option has to happen, then the voting takes place for the dividend and all that. And B class will not get, but the moment window opens for the trading, that class A and B doesn't remain, it is one class only. We have approval from the exchange also. We have opinion of the SEBI also. No issue. Legally permissive. Yeah, company is compliance, all compliance within the company. You can do classifications like that, is absolutely not an issue. And we have done it. I am not giving you examples for the sake of doing it. You see first 5 years Sun Pharma's annual reports and notices, and it is there. Exactly, I done away with that, with the saying company is on their own offering that we are going to use this. See, if company is not saying and if I am giving up, then company cannot use or do it, is a different subject. But company, I wanted the company to do it, but I am not saying you do it. Now the company itself is saying I am doing it.
Equity for the shareholders,
yeah,
and you are actually creating value also for the shareholders in terms of value. Then what was the rationale for giving a bonus when you are also paying a healthy dividend to the company and they are getting capital appreciation also?
By giving bonus, I am not giving anything. It is a split only.
So because of,
so I am not parting money. In fact, in Sun Pharma we give lot of dividends.
Yeah, that's why, sir.
Because our ability to take risk is very low. Let us be honest. And we generate so much cash, we have no borrowing, we have cash available. Now if I don't distribute, then I have to manage that cash, which also I don't want to do. So we are just opposite to Singleton. That he never given money, he never diluted the equity. We are not diluting equity practically. Split doesn't mean there is any dilution. So far internal accrual was good enough for making all these acquisitions. Yeah, we acquired. It was not one of the biggest. It grew along with us, or we grown. See, Taro we acquired for $7. $7.75 was the deal with us, and the company has offered us 65 to 70% equity by issuing additional equity and the promoter's equity to us. Today, see, we had about 2-3 years battle with the promoters to hand over his equity to us, because he find technical reason in the Israeli law that we cannot purchase his equity, which ultimately Supreme Court in Israel said no, he has to sell to us. So we acquired somewhere in 2010. The original deal we started in 2007. From 2010 till now we manage the company. Today the share is listed at about $76. So it is 10 times than what I have purchased. And we were fortunate that during the time 3 years which he managed, that time the debt of the company was $230 million, has come down to about $100 million. And after we taken over, we paid off all the debts. Except that which is not due, people has not taken, but it has been paid off now. In fact, they are cash surplus. They have about $700-800 million cash surplus in Taro itself. So fortunately, we didn't have to borrow money so far for any acquisitions. Henceforth, I may see a situation where the acquisition is larger enough. No, see, exactly, if I don't do acquisitions, then what do I do with the cash? See, I continue to grow the company and acquire, it is all majority of the growth has come from acquisition also. It's not only organic, inorganic also there is a growth. We acquired 14 companies so far, 14 companies as much to Sun Pharma. So everywhere we must have spent money to acquire the company. we have not issued any paper for acquisition so far.
According to you, what would be the three key factors that distinguish a CFO from an accounts manager?
Come again. If you ask me, account person, see, you are just talking about bookkeeping today. I think nowhere it remains bookkeeping anymore. Bookkeeping is done by the system. Computer is doing activity of accounting. Nobody is doing accounting. Now, ultimately, it is only the finance which you manage for the company is going to be important or factor. Now, three factors I am still not able, because I am not able to comprehend the accounting job remains anymore. Sorry, I am not able to answer you.